Somebody call 911. Shawty fire burning on the dance floor. Whoa. What a crime. Kingston, let's go. Hey. And this is what he did to me, okay? And this is, oh man, this was a standoff. This was a classic gunslinger moment I had with this guy. I placed my order, okay? And this is what he does to me. Listen to these shenanigans that he fucking pulls on me. If I ever see him again, I'm gonna call him shenanigans. What's up, shenanigans? This is what he does. I order my food, okay? And then I go to pay for my purchase. And I hand him the currency, okay? And then when it's time for the change portion of the exchange, I did this little move. I did this little move with my hand where you turn your hand into a tiny little bowl and you place it about 3-4 feet in front of your face. And it's a little move that says, would you please hand me my change? Because I've just changed my appearance and I'm very much like a container to easily place change in on my human flesh. And as I'm waiting, this is what the guy does. He takes my change and he sees my hand. Here's the counter. He goes and he smashes it down on the counter. And the nickels fly and the dime hits me in the eyeball. The dollar bill ripped in half and blew away in a breeze. And I was pissed off. I was in the red. And the only thing that, you know, kept me from snapping, the French fries. I looked up at that picture and they just looked so dandy. They looked so joyous. That it put me back down in the yellow, or the mustard, as I call it. I decide I'm not gonna get into it. So I sit down at the booth, right? And I'm just about to get into it. And then I realize there's no ketchup on this fucking tray. So I go up to the guy, okay? He's helping another woman. And I just wanna remind you who the guy is. He's a fucking douchebag, but I don't know why. It's just a feeling I get. He's helping this lady, and again, because I'm in charge, because I need ketchup, and I'm the most important person in the entire world, I lean in, and he's talking to her, and I start to go, excuse me, can I just get a couple of... And right in the middle of it, this is what he does to me, okay? He leans over to me, and he goes, 1 second, pal. Calls me pal. And let me tell you something, when somebody calls you pal, and you're not pals, fuck that. You know what I mean, too. 1 second, pal. It was the way he said the word pal. To you sounds like pal. To me sounded like fuckface. I still heard pal, but it was centered in a fuckface coding. It was like 1 second, fuck pal face. That's what I heard. That's honestly what I heard. And I was embarrassed. I was sullen. I was downtrodden, okay? I step back up and I go, no problem, buddy. Yeah. I went with buddy. No problem, buddy. And I even did that little head flick. And I furrowed my eyebrow right here, the best as I could, like very Klingon-like, but not as extraordinary. This guy is like a gunslinger. I gotta give him credit because before I could even blink 3 times, he was fucking quick draw McGraw right away. I don't know, he just had it ready like a katana. He just pulled it, fing! He hits me with this. I'll be right there, chief. I'm not a chief. I'm not an Indian chief. I'm not the chief of police. I don't play for the Kansas City Chiefs. I'm not a chef, which is sometimes confused with chief on paper. I've done that. As you're writing it, you're like, I'm dumb. So I step back up and I figure, you know what? I'm gonna end this. I'm gonna put the kibosh on this thing right now. It's gone too far. Pal, buddy, chief, pim, pim, pow. I say, I'm going old school on this guy right now. I'm putting the end to it. And I hit him with something that you can't come back from. I stood my ground and I just finally said, after a good breath, I went, no problem, gay lord.